Welcome to this brief guide on how to add audio to your slides in Google Slides. Have you ever found yourself trying to set the perfect mood for a presentation, or perhaps add a memorable sound effect to highlight a key point, only to be limited by silent slides? Well, you're not alone. But what if I told you that Google Slides, a tool that you're probably already familiar with, holds the key to effortlessly integrating powerful sound into your next presentation? With just a few simple steps, you can transform your presentations from ordinary to audibly engaging by seamlessly adding and controlling music and sound effects. So, let's get started. All right, let's kick things off with adding audio to your Google Slides presentation. This feature is incredibly powerful for setting a mood, providing background music during an introduction, or even adding subtle sound effects to enhance specific points. It can truly elevate the atmosphere and professionalism of your presentation, turning a good presentation into a great one. Now, before we begin, it's really important to know that Google Slides works best with audio files that are already stored in your Google Drive. So, if your audio is currently on your computer, the first step is to upload it to your Google Drive. Make sure it's in a format like MP3 or WAV, which are widely supported. Now, let's walk through the steps to insert that audio into your slide. Imagine you're preparing a presentation on a peaceful nature retreat that you're organizing. You want some calming, ambient forest sounds to play as your audience settles in, setting the mood right from the start. First, you'll need to navigate to the specific slide where you want your audio to begin playing. For our nature retreat, we'd go to the very first slide, our title slide. Once you're on the correct slide, head up to the menu bar at the top of your screen. You'll see a range of options up here. Go ahead and click on Insert. A drop-down menu will appear, and you should look for and select Audio. This will open up a new window that connects directly to your Google Drive, showing you all of your audio files. Within this window, you can use the search bar at the top to quickly find your specific file by name, or you can browse through your files down below. So, you'd search for your forest sounds or calming music track. Once you've found your desired audio file, simply click on it to select it, and then click the blue Insert button at the bottom of the window. Immediately, you'll notice a small speaker icon has appeared on your slide. This icon represents your newly inserted audio file. You can click and drag this icon to reposition it anywhere on your slide. For background music, we'll look at hiding it later for a cleaner look. Alternatively, if you were presenting some important sales figures for the quarter and you wanted a short celebratory sound effect to highlight positive growth, you would follow these same steps, but you'd insert a short success chime audio file on the specific slide where those figures appear. Once you've inserted your audio, Google Slides gives you powerful control over how it plays. This is where you can truly customize the audio experience to fit your presentation's flow and timing. It's not just about getting the sound in there, but making sure it behaves exactly how you want it to, seamlessly integrating it into your presentation. With the speaker icon still selected on your slide, you'll notice an audio playback sidebar automatically appears on the right-hand side of your screen. Now, if for some reason it doesn't appear, simply right-click on the speaker icon and select Format Options. This will open the same sidebar. Now let's explore these crucial options, keeping our nature retreat presentation in mind where we want continuous, calming background music. Start playing. This determines when your audio begins. First, we have On Click. Now if you select this, the audio will only play when you actually click the speaker icon during your live presentation. Now this is perfect for specific sound effects that you want to trigger at a precise moment, like that celebratory sound for your sales figures. You'd click it exactly when the numbers appear. Next is Automatically. Now if you choose this, the audio will start playing as soon as you land on that specific slide during your presentation. For our nature retreat background music, this is exactly what we want. It begins smoothly without any action required from you, setting the atmosphere immediately as the audience sees your title slide. Stop on slide change. This option controls whether your audio continues playing as you advance through your slides. If this box is checked, the audio will stop playing as soon as you move to the next slide. This is useful if you want a short one-slide soundbite, like a quick sound effect for a quiz answer. However, for our continuous nature retreat background music, we want it to span several introductory slides, so we would uncheck this box. This ensures the audio continues to play seamlessly across multiple slides until the entire audio track ends, creating a consistent ambience throughout your presentation. Volume. This is a simple but vital slider that lets you adjust how loud your audio is. For background music like our retreat ambience, you drag the slider to a soft, appropriate level so that it complements your voice without overpowering it. Kind of like the music in this video. Now always, always test this out before your live presentation. Hide icon when presenting. If you check this box, the speaker icon will become completely invisible to your audience during the slideshow. For our background music, this is essential for a cleaner, more professional look, as the icon itself isn't part of our visual design. Just keep in mind that this option is not available if you have the audio set to play on click, but I will show you a workaround for this in just a moment. Loop audio. If this box is checked, the audio will repeat continuously from the beginning once it reaches its end, looping until you change slides or your presentation concludes. If your introduction to the nature retreat is lengthy and you want the music to continue seamlessly without interruption, you would definitely check this box. So, to fully set up that continuous, calming background music for your nature retreat presentation, you would insert the audio onto your very first slide, set Start Playing to automatically, and then crucially uncheck Stop on Slide Change. You'd adjust your volume to a soft, appropriate level, make sure to hide the icon during the presentation for a clean look, and potentially loop audio if you want it to play for a long duration across multiple slides. Once your audio speaker icon is inserted onto your slide, you'll also have full control over its appearance and its precise placement. This is absolutely essential for creating a polished and professional look for your presentation. You don't want your icon awkwardly placed, distracting from your content. So, let's look at how to manipulate the audio icon on your slide. First, let's cover resizing. To change the size of your selected audio icon, simply click and drag any of the small blue squares located at the corners of the object. As you drag, the icon will resize. You might make it smaller to be less intrusive, or larger if it's part of a deliberate visual design element on your slide. Then we have positioning. To move your icon, simply click and drag it anywhere on the slide. As you move it, you'll notice the red guidelines appearing on the slide. These can be incredibly helpful for accurate placement. They automatically snap into place to help you align your icon perfectly with other elements on your slide, or precisely with the center of the slide, both horizontally and vertically. This helps ensure everything looks neat and balanced. Now, if you want your audio to play on click, but you don't want that speaker icon visible to your audience, a great strategy is to position the icon in an inconspicuous corner of your slide, like the bottom right, where there's usually nothing happening. This keeps it accessible for you to click during your presentation, but out of the way for your audience. Then we have rotation. Above the selected object, you'll see a small circular handle. Click and drag this handle to rotate your object. While rarely needed for a simple audio icon, the option is there for highly specific design needs. So for our nature retreat presentation, where the audio is background music and will play automatically and be hidden, its size and position don't really matter as much. But for audio that you want to trigger on click, placing it in that bottom right corner and then making it invisible using the transparency setting we'll look at next is the perfect solution. Beyond just playback and basic sizing, Google Slide offers additional formatting options that can really make your audio icon blend seamlessly into your design or even disappear entirely when needed. With our speaker or icon selected, ensure the Format Options sidebar is open on the right-hand side. If it's not, remember that you can right-click the object and select Format Options. Let's explore the most powerful adjustments that we can make for your audio icon. In this case, specifically, transparency. This is where you can make your audio icon completely invisible to your audience while keeping it active and clickable for you. Simply adjust the opacity slider all the way to 0%. This will make the icon fully transparent, effectively hiding it from view during your slideshow, even though it's still present and functional on the slide. This is ideal for those on-click audio triggers where you want to maintain control without cluttering your visual presentation. Other formatting options like drop shadow and reflection are generally not needed for a functional icon that will be hidden. The main goal here is discrete control. So for our on-click audio example, once you've positioned your icon in a discrete corner like the bottom right, you'll simply go to these format options, navigate to adjustments, and set the opacity slider to 0%. This way, you'll retain the ability to click it during your presentation, but your audience will never know it's there. And there you have it. We've now covered all of the essential tips to master adding and controlling audio in your Google Slides presentations. By leveraging these audio features, you're no longer just creating silent slides. You're crafting auditory experiences that can enhance mood, emphasize points, and truly capture your audience's attention. So go ahead and experiment with sound. Try adding a subtle background track for your next introduction or a punchy sound effect for a key revelation. See how much more engaging your next presentation can be with the power of audio. Don't forget, Google Slides is a free web-based tool that's accessible with any Google account. Simply open your browser and navigate to slides.google.com and start creating your next amazing presentation today. And I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.